Hi Neil again. Just a quickie, I was doing a survey this morning and following on from a surveyor who's actually done a home buyers report. And what he mentioned was that there was evidence of damp on the front main elevation. Obviously in this location which I'm pointing to, which is the front left hand corner of the bedroom. Now there's elevated moisture meter readings up to around about 1.5 meters high. So he was absolutely spot on to pick this up. And what he did recommend is that there was further investigation required. So hence the reason I've ended up here this morning. So I'm going to take you outside and the source of the water ingress. Now it was raining earlier on, but it's, of course it's stopped. But what we've got is on the external rainwater goods, this dump cover. We've got a problem. Obviously, we can see by the algae, everything around there, that it's obviously been leaking. When I came earlier on, there was water running out of there. These are solid walls. Yep, solid 9-inch walls. You can see the staining down there, so it's a good indication that rainwater penetration, is likely to occur in this location. So again, the surveyor then said we recommend that any timbers in that location are inspected, as they will be at risk of fungal decay. So what I've done, I came in and popped up a floorboard in that location. Now I'm going to try and put this underneath the floor. And now, for some reason, my light isn't working. Now I'm going to see why. There you are. So I pop this under the floor. Now what we've got, the floor timbers themselves are pretty good. There's no real issue with them. But what I did notice, which is the two joists which I'm looking at there, if I can focus in, on the ends of the joists where that rainwater penetration's been occurring, we've actually got a slight outbreak of wet rot in the joist ends, the two joist ends. And we've also got a bit of wood boring weevil. Now, wood boring weevil is obviously a wood boring insect that generally infests timber with a very high moisture content, and normally timber that's already affected by its decay to some degree. But so underneath the floor, the rest of the joists generally pretty good. From here, I can see through into the lounge. And I have zoomed in earlier, but for the purpose of this, I'll see if I can zoom in a little bit further. So they're the two joist ends. I don't know if you can pick it up, but there is, as I say, a bit of wet rot and a bit of wood boring weevil on the joist ends. Those two joists are the joists that straddle the stud wall partition that's directly above. But as I say, looked at the rest of the floors, generally everything is better than expected. But I thought fair play to the surveyor. He picked up on the fact that there was, he or she picked up on the fact that there was a potential for rainwater penetration, or there was a problem with damp, and recommended further investigation because timbers in close proximity may well be affected by fungal decay, and it's exactly what has happened. Not a huge problem, not a significant problem, but if it's left unattended, obviously these things can progress and become more serious. Now, what I have noted, I popped up floorboards in a few locations. We've got 96 air bricks on the front, we've got 96 air bricks on the rear. But the moisture content of the timbers is around about 22%. There's very little evidence of fungal decay other than the location which I've just pointed out. But obviously, coming along, into which is the back room, the rear room, the lounge, and the moisture content of the timbers is pretty much rounded between 17 and 22%, which is a little bit higher than we'd like. Obviously, ideally, we'd want it to be below 20%. But what I've noticed is this is really typical on the partition wall between the front room and the rear room. It's a solid wall. Ideally, there should have been sockets for this. Well, ideally, it would have been honeycombed, so we'd have had a decent cross flow ventilation. But as you can see, it's solid in between the joists. It's solid brickwork. So whilst we've put the air brakes in the front and the air brakes in the rear, we haven't given them a chance to obviously function properly. If you look at the cobwebs, it's a really good giveaway. There's a slight breeze outside, but there's absolutely, you know, apart from the fact I've just breathed there, but you know, go away from that and there's very, very little movement on the cobwebs. I can't feel any air movement below the floor. But this is a common problem where we think, we look and we think, oh, well, you know, there's three air brakes on the front, three on the rear, so we're going to be fine. But this partition wall between the two rooms is the problem when it's solid. So ideally, to get cross-flow ventilation, what we need to do is knock a few sockets out, a few holes out in that partition wall just below the joists. And that'll get the air moving between the two rooms, front to rear, rear to front, depending on which way the wind's blowing. But I thought it was a handy little tip. You know, you can look and think, yep, we've got plenty of air brakes there, but are they actually being allowed to function? In this case, they're not. But this is a really typical problem. And hence, you know, looking at that externally, I thought there shouldn't be a problem. But when you're getting moisture content, the worst I got was, or the highest I got was slightly over the room. I took a board up and it was 25% moisture content in the joists. So that's quite high. We're getting to the territory where fungal decay is becoming a risk, a significant risk. So it's always worth bearing in mind, you know, you may have a look at the air brakes, but is it a case of, or is there solid walls between them which are preventing the air brakes from working effectively? I hope this makes sense. Okay, and I hope it helps those less experienced surveyors. Take care now. All the best. Neil.